is Red Carpet Diary from the Toronto International Film Festival. I'm Joan Kelly. Harry Brown is a tough look at the state of modern Britain through the eyes of the title character, played by Sir Michael Caine. The film was directed by Daniel Barber. He and Emily Mortimer, the co-star of the film, visited us here in the Smashbox suite at the Hazelton Hotel to speak about the film.
How do you want to come for, brother?
I want to shoot pigeons off my roof.
Well, of course you do. Of course you do.
It has important social comments that it makes, you know, relative to English society. There's a lot of problems in Britain at the moment, as there are in different places in the world, obviously, America and a lot of parts of Europe. But, you know, the whole kind of situation in Britain with the problems we have with youth, violence and drugs, which is highlighted in the film, is something which we need to have a serious conversation about in Britain.
It's about a vigilante pensioner, an old age pensioner who turns vigilante. And it's set in a kind of housing estate projects in England in the present day somewhere. It's pretty non-specific as to where it's set. And I play the police detective who starts to realise that that Michael Caine is bumping off hoodies, as we call them.
You don't have anyone to play with.
Not since then.
You could always get one of those chess computer game things.
You didn't come here to talk about chess.
There's something of the Western about this film, and I think the director, Daniel Barber, was aware of that. I mean, it's subtle, but it's there, especially in the kind of shots that he chooses. And so Michael Caine is the vigilante character and I'm the sheriff, you know, in some ways, the sort of Tommy Lee Jones character.
Now, before you say another word, he was using it as protection. I mean, that man, he was frightened, terrified. These kids on the estate, they were harassing him. He came to me and asked me for help. I said, why don't you go and talk to the police?
Well, that was the right thing to do.
Oh, was it? He told me to talk to the police. And what did you lot do? Nothing.
Well, that may be true, but I have a problem. Counsel will argue that whoever killed Mr. Atwell did so out of self-defense, which means they'll be charged with manslaughter, not murder.
Jesus Christ. You came here to tell me that.
And by the end of the film, I think I have started to question my entire stance on justice.
Yeah.
And put in a state of sort of total confusion and disarray, and my very persistence in following the letter of the law and my belief in it ends up in the death of my sergeant, really. You know, my determination to find justice at all costs ends up with a good guy getting killed, and I think that kind of destroys my faith in what I held true up until that point.
I hope this film is an experience for an audience to see. It's not going to be comfortable viewing all the time. There are parts of the film, as you know, which are uncomfortable, very tiring to look at, and demanding of an audience because they engage. And that's what I want to do as a filmmaker. I want to create films, I want to make things which grab people. The script on paper, for me, initially was a very interesting idea, but it needed, I felt, quite a lot of work. And I worked with the writer and developed it. But actually, the script really came alive when we started to do rehearsals with Michael, Emily, Ben Drew, who plays Noel, and so on. And I began to realise that there was a lot more we could get out of the scenes. And we worked with the actors and with stunt people to devise and choreograph the scenes. in a way that felt very natural for the actors, but also pushed them as to what they could do. We did a lot of improvisation on set, which I think some of the interesting dialogue comes from. And I think the language that the kids use, which is totally real and of the streets, you know, you can't script that. What we did is we scripted the intent of what they would say, but then we let them say, interpret it as they wanted to say things.
Okay, so basically you're every actor's dream.
I don't know about that, but I really very much care for the actors, and for me performance is an absolute priority. But you can only have great performance if you have great storyline and great dialogue, so it all comes from that initially. And all the actors in the piece were very good with me, in that they allowed me the freedom to ask of them things which maybe they would not ordinarily do.
Well, I think you definitely did that, and you took the audience for a ride. I think audiences are going to love this film, and they're really going to believe the struggles that these characters are going through.
I want people to like my film, obviously, but more than that, if they don't like it, at least I want it to get a reaction. You know, hate my film then, or be uncomfortable with my film, but I want it to cause something from people, you know.